I created an AI for my game 1 Minute, which was created for the Wowie game jam. The goal in this game is to go as far as you can by avoiding these red obstacles. There are also two types of collectibles. The shiny yellow ones increase your speed and the spiky spheres reduce it a little bit. My goal was to create an AI with machine learning that plays well, if not perfectly, and can defeat me in this game. My highest score was 154, so this will be the goal. In the end of the video, the big competition will be held between me and the amazing AI, so make sure you stay until the end. I will create the AI using Unity's mlagents package, which enables games and simulations to serve as environments for training intelligent agents. But how can it learn? How does machine learning work? There are a bunch of different problems that can be solved with machine learning. For example, if you have a lot of images with boots and cats on them,
boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats,
and the goal for the AI is to watch an image and decide if it's a cat or boots, then it's a classification problem. There are also a problem type called clustering, where you have a bunch of data and you have to group those into clusters based on their features. But what we will use now is called reinforcement learning. In this area of machine learning, we have an agent in an environment. The agent can interact with the environment by performing different actions. Based on the result of the action, we give it some reward, which can be negative if it did something wrong, or positive if it did something good. This is the learning phase. It performs a lot of actions and receives a lot of positive or negative rewards and slowly get to know the environment, so it will know in which cases which actions should be made, if everything goes well. And Unity's mlagents is made for training agents using reinforcement learning. It uses a construction called artificial neural networks, or neural networks for short. The network has some input and some output nodes and a few hidden layers between them. Each node, called a neuron, is connected to every other neuron in the previous and the next layer. Each connection has a weight that represents the importance of that connection. The output of each neuron is counted by some function of the sum of the inputs. The goal of the learning phase is to tweak the weights so the agent gains more rewards based on actions made by the given output. I quickly set up the project for training. I also cut out the animations for destroying a wall, because it used too much resources and we don't need the animations for the training. To start, we need some observations, which will be the input of the neural network. In mlagents, there are three types of observations: simple numbers, ray perception sensors, and image sensors. So first question, what observations should be used? I tried out a lot of different combinations. For all of them, I used two simple numbers, the X position and the speed of the character, so the agent knows where it is and how fast it moves. Of course, this is not enough. It has to know what's happening on the track. For this, I used ray perception sensors. These are basically rays coming from the center of the agent. We can select which game object should be detected by the rays, so we can make the agent see only the walls if we want to, or place more rays to detect different types of objects. From each ray we get some information if it hits a game object, which the agent will use to dodge the walls. I tried out a few different combinations. In the final and best version, I used 3 sets of rays. The first checks the walls, the second checks the yellow collectibles, and the third checks the spiky spheres. This was just a little bit better compared to a previous version, when I used only one set of rays to detect only the walls. But you know, every point matters. Now we have the observations, so the input of the neural network. Next step is to figure out what actions can the agent make. The game itself is really easy. You can go left or right, so this will be the one and only action, so a number between -1 and 1. If it's negative, the agent goes left, if it's positive, it goes right, and if it's 0, it stays in place. Last step is to make the reward system. This is a very important step. If you do this wrong, the network learns a completely different thing, which we don't want to, so let's think a little bit. If we ignore the collectibles, the formula is really easy. If you go ahead, that's good, if you collide with a wall, that's bad. So I gave it a small reward in every frame, based on its speed. This means the 10th of your score you see, so if the agent collects 100 points, it receives a total of 10 reward during the whole game. For every wall hit, I gave the agent -1 reward, which is really big compared to the small rewards, so if all goes well, it will learn that colliding is a really bad thing and should be avoided. What can we do with the collectibles? You might think that the speed-up collectibles are good and the slow-down collectibles are wrong. But that's not the case. If you move too fast, you need to collect the slowdown collectibles to be able to dodge the walls in time, so the problem is more difficult. I experimented a lot with these, giving a small bonus for collecting speed-up collectibles, small negative for slowdown collectibles, and also try to give a small reward for every one of them, regardless of its type. But the best solution was not giving any reward nor penalty for picking up any collectible. So the agent can see those but won't get any rewards for collecting them, so it should find out what are those for and when should be collected. I had a few training sessions, I will show you some of the results. After a few tries, finally I get the first promising results where the agent could achieve a reward around 0, which means that it hits a wall around 6 to 8 times in each round and can get a final score around 60. The next one was a bit better with an above 0 reward, but the score was still below 80, so very far from the goal. In the previous experiments, I used only the wall detection arrays, and when I added the other ones, it got a bit better, as you can see. And actually, this was the best one, after a few tweaks. The highest score was 203, which is far better than I expected, but the average was only 120 to 130. I thought I could improve that, but it turned out I couldn't. The previous agents learn everything from scratch by their experiences. Now I'll try a method called imitation learning, where you provide some data for the agent, which tells it which action is good, which is not. I played the game several times, about 80 rounds, and the agent started to learn based on those data and tried to improve that. Sadly, the score wasn't better than the previous agent's score, the top was around 180, the average was nearly the same. But if you compare those two agents, you can see a difference. The one which has been taught with imitation learning is understanding the game better, so in most cases it collects the yellow collectibles when its speed is low and doesn't collect them if the speed is high. Challenge time. After I had the two best agents, I thought it would be great if I could compete with them in a fair competition. For that, I needed to add the competition mode to the game. In this mode, the two players compete with each other by playing on the exact same track, one after another. So I had to modify the track generation script to be able to generate the same tracks with the same collectibles on them for both players. I also made a UI for it, which displays each score, so we can see who won which round. I wanted to play against the best AI, so in the first round of the competition, the two competitors will be the two best agents. On the left side you can see the traditional, on the right side you can see the one which has been taught with imitation learning. After the competition, we can see that the winner is obviously the traditional AI, who learned everything by itself. The big time has come. Me versus the AI. The first round wasn't too good for me, so the AI won that with a decent score. The same applies to the next few rounds, each time the AI could collect more points. It's already 4-0 for the AI, but I still have chance. The fifth round was really great for me, now I have my first win. But after that, it beats me again 2 times, so it's over to my chances, even a draw is not possible now. Then on the 8th round, I could win once again. But then on the 9th round, with my best score, I lose again. And the same in the 10th round. So the result of the competition is 8-2, the AI won. This is great news, because this means the AI is very skillful, so I'm happy with the results. After the official competition, I tried to defeat it a few times, but the best result was a draw. So it's not unbeatable, but very strong. Press the thumbs up button if you like contents like this, press dislike if you don't, and check out the video on the screen right now if you are interested in the process of making the original game for the wowie gamejam.